volare. Oh, cantare. Oh, 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 nel blu degli occhi tuoi blu, felice di stare qua giù. Nel blu degli occhi tuoi blu, felice di stare qua giù.
Hello friends, we're at the airport. So this is our first Euro trip in ages, obviously with everything going on.
See, almost 2 years.
Clayton is absolutely frazzled.
I'm so frazzled. You guys, I chased down our taxi driver because I thought I left something in the car, only to find out I didn't. I was sprinting down the drop off.
Balenciaga triple S.
I told Delaney I sounded like a Clydesdale. Just skirting.
I should have taped it, but I didn't know what he thought was going on.
She didn't know what was going on. She was just like, whatever.
I wasn't like ready to film, but it was funny. Out of a movie.
And now I keep on being like, where's my wallet?
Where's it? It's freaking out. So we're whipping out some CBD gummies for him. He needs to calm down. Will calm his nerves. Do you have two?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna take one too. Just like getting relaxed for the flight.
Not really that nervous. I'm not nervous.
No.
I have a hard time because I normally always have my things in my pockets and then I start putting things in bags. Because it's like I have this bag, why not put stuff in it?
Is there a little medical bag? It's all the medicines.
So I needed such a good job packing everything.
It's a little necessity bags in here. We got all the goods.
Like five different little bags. I had the big bag.
Living Kale picked up snacks for us.
Yep.
We got snacks ready to go. So yeah, we got to the airport really early because, like I said, we haven't done this in a long time. So just wanted to be overly prepared.
Picture prepared.
So we're just chilling now, which feels good. It's way better than rushing.
It's like almost 2 hours till our flight.
Yeah. So then we were like, what should we do? And then we decided we are going to just like walk around the airport, like do some laps because we're not going to be able to walk much today. And we do want to sleep on one of the flights since like we're going so far. We don't want to get jet lagged and stuff. Right. So maybe a couple laps will tire us out.
Oh, I got tired out.
From running?
Yeah. But it's sprinted. There you go. It was a morning sprint.
That was good.
A morning sprint after a latte.
Yeah. So. Oh, great. That's the vibe.
Yeah, so
we're feeling good. We're excited.
Yeah, we're on our way to Italy. We're gonna stop. We have a couple layovers, but we're going to Sicily. And the process to get in is like pretty chill. You just need to be vaccinated and also present a negative COVID test, and then they also have like another form to fill out. But it's
a lot.
Traveling is way more
complicated now, for sure.
It's a lot, but it's like completely
doable.
Worth it.
And worth it, for sure.
Yeah, but it is like way more complicated. Like we used to just show up and show your passport.
Complicated to begin with, but now with everything else, it's just like another layer.
Yeah.
But it's okay.
Yeah.
It's worth it.
Every country has like some different rules too, so if you are planning international travel, just make sure you're double checking, triple checking what they need. If you're gonna be traveling soon, just make sure you're looking into all that.
Yep.
It's getting turned away in another country, which is like going to be a nice long trip. I think we're going to have like 3 vlogs for you guys at least.
That's the goal.
So
we're going to try to stay up on our content, but we are going to like relax and soak it in probably more than we have on other trips because this is just like long overdue for us.
So
let's go to freaking Europe,
let's
y'all.
Let's do it.
Thank you.
26 hours later.
Oh my God, it's so worth it.
You guys, this room, I mean this place in general, is just absolutely beautiful. I love the headboard here.
Yeah, it's like a littler.
Uh-huh, it's so cool. I mean, it goes side to side, but it just goes up in the middle. So they gave us a complimentary upgrade. Lucked out with that. This is like a nice suite.
No likes.
No likes. We're working on our likes. Sorry guys, I say the word likes so much.
So do I.
It's not like nice, it's nice.
It is nice.
Tell them where we are.
We are in Taormina. Taormina.
Taormina. Sicily.
Sorry, butchering that pronunciation.
Which is in Italy.
Italy.
It's our little room. And now for the absolutely stunning view too. Look at this. Delaney's already used up all of her Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
She was here for like 2 minutes. We hadn't even got our freaking bags from the bag claim. And she already used it. I don't know, mine hasn't gone up yet. Okay, well we are literally really exhausted.
We're living.
But we're not gonna.
I'm freaking stoked.
I just feel a little weird. I also had a very bad face rash on the plane.
Oh my God, that was.
I put on like a face mask and then suddenly.
Insert something here.
And I also have an ingrown toenail, and I accidentally just kicked it. What did you think of your first class experience?
Ruined.
I think I absolutely ruined her.
Don't ever put me somewhere that's not first class. No,
I'm
just
screwed.
Kidding. You don't have to do that. But it was so lovely. It was the best surprise.
This is kind of a surprise too. You didn't know
about
this room.
I have surprises coming all trip.
Yeah. You do, sweetheart. You do.
I didn't see any of the places that he booked. Like, he's basically my travel agent. Oh my God, it's so pretty, this view.
This
what
view.
Is that, like, what is that, like, vine-covered?
That building?
Oh, I just said, like,
damn. Don't say like.
What is that vine-covered?
What is that? Thing? Let's zoom in on it.
I can't believe how pretty this is. I feel crazy.
It's so pretty. Love it.
Today we are down at the beach at our hotel.
It's so beautiful.
I mean, unreal.
Breathtaking.
Yeah.
I love the sand too. It's like pebbly.
Yeah. It's a little pebble. It's a little pebble. So we're just gonna chill by the beach.
Pebbles. Take a few rocks home.
We're just gonna chill by the beach for a little while, get some snacks, get some drinks. And last night we had a great dinner.
Such a good dinner, but
what?
The mosquitoes.
Oh my God, yes. Mosquitoes.
Delaney got bit in the ear.
Oh yeah.
Can you show? She literally has cauliflower.
Can you guys tell how swollen my ear is?
It's not okay.
So yeah.
Really bad mosquitoes here, so we got.
Apparently they're like famous for having bad mosquitoes. I did not know, and. Yeah. I was very unpleasantly surprised by that. I was like, what? No, there's not gonna be mosquitoes in Italy. Oh, but there is, there's something.
You were just
else.
Romanticizing it.
I was totally romanticizing
Never
it.
Never would there be mosquitoes.
Yeah, I'm like, that just doesn't, they just don't seem to fit the vibe in Italy.
One thing I learned last night and this morning is the Italians love their sleep.
Really?
Yeah, because.
How do you know?
Because every room, and then when you look around the town, they have blackout shutters on the house.
That's a European thing.
Okay, the European.
Remember, Spain has that too.
Oh yeah, yeah. Anyways, I think that's our first experience
I think
with
just
it.
Smart, like.
Oh yeah, it's just like smart. Because
so
it's like, why not just like make your room dark? And it was pitch
extra,
black.
Extra like security. Too.
Yeah, we woke up at like 10:30, and it was pitch black in the room.
Mm-hmm.
Like I didn't know what time it was, I didn't know if it was bright out yet, or what was going on.
I think we successfully beat the jet lag.
I feel good.
Yeah.
I feel like a little weird, but I think it's just
but
because
we didn't,
like
we didn't go to bed at a weird time, or waking up at a super weird time.
No. Went to bed at 1, woke up at 10:30.
Yeah.
I think it's just the day before, technically, we only had like 4 hours of sleep.
Yeah. But we slept on the plane, we took our melatonin on the plane, kind of knocked us out for a decent amount of time, and then we took some naps here and there on the flights where we could. Stayed up till midnight when we got here, didn't take a nap or anything when we got here. And I feel we beat it. I was feeling pretty funny last night because we had traveled for 25 hours and then we had like 2 glasses of wine and I was ready to go. Covered in mosquito bite.
Covered in mosquito bite with cauliflower. Actually, that didn't start till this morning.
Yeah. And also, while we're on this trip, we talk about this in our video on our diet anyways, but if you guys haven't seen that, while we're on our trip, we do like to experience the culture and try the foods and stuff. We never eat meat. We eat seafood regularly anyways. We don't cook it at home, but we eat it. Like, it's a part of our diet anyway, so of course we're gonna have that. And also while we're here, we'll have some dairy.
Cheese.
Yeah, we wanna experience.
How can you not?
You know, Italian food and stuff. I wouldn't eat like an egg, or like a glass of milk or something. That just seems unnecessary to me. But if there was an egg cooked into something or cheese, we'll have it. We'll try it. So it's kind of the premise for the food that we'll be trying on this trip. And also in our video about how much we drink and stuff, we also mentioned when we go on vacation, we tend to have more alcohol than we would at home. So like, we're at the beach today, we're probably gonna have a cocktail or
like 15 bottles of wine.
If anyone was confused or anything, there is the 411 on the food and beverage diet of the trip. Cheers. Also, we need to know what you guys think. So Clayton got these Gucci loafers a while back, which is a really nice shoe for him. He's worn them a lot. I think that he should have got the ones that didn't have a back because he's kind of that kind of guy, a backless guy.
Lazy.
Yeah, but he wanted those ones, but now he is doing the thing where he just steps on the back.
Just during the day, you know, when I'm going back and forth to the beach or something, at night I'm gonna do this, no doubt.
Do we think that's okay to do to those? I feel like it's gonna ruin them. I feel like it's not a good thing to do to a nice shoe.
They seem to be pretty resilient. Weigh in.
Share your thoughts, but if they do get ruined, they'll probably be ruined by the time you vote, so. But cheer anyway.
Cheers. Dripping. Yeah. Bitter.
Really bitter?
Yeah. I got a, what do you call it? Etna?
Etna.
Etna spritz. Made with Campari.
Mine's good at tasting.
Do you want to try one?
No.
Just so you know. This one is apparently the house fave.
Or like local food or something.
Yeah.
So
better. So bad. Stopped up here for lunch. This is a little restaurant at the hotel.
It's so pretty.
The best view ever.
Every seat.
Yeah, every seat's literally so nice.
We're having some oysters.
Got some oysters.
Serve them with crackers, quite like they do in Florida, but.
Sure, they'll be delicious. They look so good. Just got a bottle of wine, Sicily white wine. Cheers, baby.
Today we decided to walk over to, what's it?
Isola Bella.
So it's just like 2 minutes from our hotel. And we heard the wildlife in the water here is amazing. It's really good for snorkeling. You can see so much. We don't have goggles or snorkel gear or anything, but walking down, they have just a bunch of street vendors and you can buy that there. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe we should.
Yeah.
Because we walked over here. Also, it's just like super rocky, you know, sand.
Smaller pebbles over
here. It's kind of hard to walk on. And they have these like, water shoes for sale everywhere. We should actually probably get
those. Be easier on your foot.
Yeah. Claudia said they're like the best thing here. And she's Sicilian, so we're gonna take her word for it. Just kind of adventuring over here today. Our hotel is so pretty and the beach is so nice there, but
just wanted to see a little bit more.
Exactly. So just wandered over here and it's really beautiful.
Da 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 da. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- You okay?
Mm-hmm.
So you're wearing a skirt.
What do you think?
Some fuzzy slides. Cute. Very cute. Well, outfits. Tonight's our last night, actually. Whoa. Jeez. Tonight's our last night in this hotel, unfortunately. We're going to have to say goodbye to this.
I know, but we're going somewhere else. Cool.
Yep. Got a bunch of other nice days on the trip. Tonight, we're going up to town to go to a restaurant called Baronessa.
Mm-hmm.
So we take the little shuttle from this hotel up to their other one. And then we will walk to dinner. Shall we?
We shall.
It's so humid.
Very humid.
Buonasera.
Okay, so last night we were here with Claudia. That's whose wedding we're here for, and she's from here. She told us this myth about these head planters. So basically there's a legend that a Sicilian woman was married to a, or no, she was seeing a man from North Africa, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then she found out that he had a family and a wife and everything back in home in Africa, and she didn't want him to go back home to them. So the rumor or the myth is that she chopped his head off and put it on her balcony as a planter, and everyone walked by and loved the planter and wanted to know where she got it from. And yeah, that's basically the story. So it's kind of creepy, but some history.
Historian. Delaney's a historian.
Buongiorno. We moved to an Airbnb, and Michelle and Blake, some of our friends, are coming to this Airbnb as well. They were in Spain first, so they're not here yet, but I'll show you guys a little bit what it looks like, because it's really interesting to me always to see inside of actual homes in different countries and cultures. So this is an apartment technically, but it's huge. This is the kitchen. Yeah, it's so big. We're not in a city, so I think there's more room. Here's built-ins.
Like, yeah, this is like a vacation town.
Here's this cutie. I love his outfit today. Show us your outfit. Love. So cute. But we did have it packed with Doc Martens, and I do think that would have made it cuter.
Yeah, these are my new boots.
Huh?
Yeah, but these are my new boots.
I know. They're cute too.
They're my new boots.
Okay.
Don't be mean, my new boots.
I am not. This view is stunning.
Got the sea to your right, mountains to the left. We have a pool.
Gorge. There's like little.
So in this bathroom, right in this bathroom, sure.
Yeah, this bathroom's cool. It has Sicilian tiles. And this thing is really pretty. We're both wearing trousers. Or no, you're wearing jeans. I'm wearing trousers.
Jeans.
So that's just a little sneak. Not sneak peek, because I'm not really going to show more, but what's going on?
Learning how to use the doors. This is a.
That seems kind of scary. Is that okay? I feel like it's freaking. We are about to go. We're gonna be in town now. We were down at the ocean.
Sea.
We're gonna explore town, which we're excited for. A little different vibe. Still just really small vacation town, like Clayton said. We are not feeling the best.
No. I'm still feeling, I don't know if I'm feeling sick or something or what it is, but.
I think it's probably just jet lag.
Yeah, it's jet lag. I thought jet lag was more of like a always being tired kind of thing, but I think I'm more like internally.
Just off.
Yeah, just internally body clock's off. Mm-hmm. Like I'm hungry, but I'm not hungry, and then no meal is like fully filling me up, kind of.
Like filling you up or filling you up? I think that we thought we beat the jet lag because we got on a pretty good schedule. It wasn't the best schedule, but we went to sleep around
one
and then we're waking up around 10, which isn't terrible. I mean, that's not normal for us back home, but we thought that was pretty good. But then we're just not feeling that good. And I am pretty tired. But I don't feel tired walking around and stuff.
No.
So,
it's just kind of weird. Yeah, it's just jet lag
a bit. And then food hasn't been our favorite, actually.
No.
To be completely honest. And maybe we're just eating at the wrong places so far. Obviously, we're still going to give it a go.
We're going to try tons of places. We're going to go eat a bunch of places.
And it's not bad food, but it's just maybe not our favorite. It feels very heavy.
Yeah, heavy.
For us. We need more.
I think we should go find a salad right now.
Yeah.
Salad and pizza.
Yeah. That'd be good.
See the pizza, pasta.
It's just sandwiches. Heavy for us. And maybe because it's so hot, it's hard to eat such heavy food right now, too. Mm-hmm. It's not bad, but maybe we're just not cut out for it.
Yeah, let's go see what we can find. I'm also wondering if we're like a little dehydrated. We didn't drink too much water at the hotel. They like give you like a bottle of water each night. But we weren't like drinking a bunch of water throughout the day. So at this Airbnb, they had some waters in the fridge. So I'm going to be absolutely chugging water because maybe I'm just like a little dehydrated and my insides are just not working right. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I met a couple people on our bus ride last night back and forth from the
town
to our hotel at the beach, and their point was it's like Taormina is a cool place to visit because you have the beach.
It's like a cool place to visit, or it is
a cool place to visit. Stop it. I say like too much.
I thought we told the vlog we're working on our...
I know we are.
Eliminating.
Yeah, and it's not going well.
It's going
but
well. It's getting better. Oh.
She said a buzzer. Here it is. Pretty much their take on Taormina, and I kind of have to agree, is that it's nice because you can experience
which
the
way
beach.
Do we want to go?
This way. But then also experience like a little town.
Yeah, so that is really cool.
That is pretty cool. It's not like a beach town, like we're up in like a different area.
Like a different
God
area?
God damn it. That was quick. I feel like this is like, I think this is how we do it. I really feel like we, when just we go to eat, we like, oh here, this place looks good. We don't even think about it. This is literally like the first restaurant on our walk in town. We're not even to town center yet.
Okay, but I saw their menu, like the sign. Not like the sign. The sign? The literal sign. It's not like a sign, it is a sign. I saw all these pastas and some of them looked familiar. Yeah. And so I was like, no, I wasn't like. I was literally.
I said it. I swear I said it.
Yeah, I saw it and I was sold.
This works too because it's hot, so we don't have to walk too far.
Yeah. And we have to meet Michelle and Blake are going to be there soon. So just popped right in, and they have salads on the list too. That's a good sign.
I was like trying to talk Delaney out of it.
Yeah, he was like, no, he wasn't like. He said, should we keep going? Should we try somewhere else? Why not?
But it's so true because you might as well just try it.
Seems
because we could have walked around and then I could have wandered us into the wrong place or something.
It looks good. They have some like, not like, they have some simpler things. Tomato and basil sauce.
Yeah, see, this is what I'm talking about.
That seems
which maybe some rigatoni.
Lighter.
I'm excited.
And just.
I'm excited.
Maybe better for us.
Delaney gives me such a hard time with my Italian. That's.
Is that trash? It's not trash.
I get scared. I get scared when it comes time to perform. Okay, so far, I'm excited for this meal. We had arugula on our salad last night. They like to use arugula. And we got a little mozzarella added to this. This looks delicious. I feel like this is the start of what we need.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree?
Simple vegetables.
Please, please, please. There's also never like an option for salad dressings really, so they always bring out olive oil and balsamic, salt, and you do it yourself.
Love that.
I got a good little salad dressing maker with me too.
Let's eat some veggies.
Let's see what she thinks. Good start.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here's the pasta.
It looks really good.
Yeah. I got the Norma, which is apparently the famous Sicilian dish.
Yeah, that's what Claudia said.
That's what our friend Claudia said. And Delaney got Parmesan sauce and pistachio. Looks really good. How is it? It's good. Yummy, yum, yum.
This is more speed. It's like not as fancy.
Yeah, like a larger plate for sure already.
The food is getting better for me so far. Wait, can you close
that? Yeah.
There's not enough room on this countertop. My hair's
cocktail wedding adventure. Whoa, you got curly hair?
Mm-hmm.
You went hard on the hair store.
I went hard.
So we have welcome drinks tonight.
Yes.
And we're going kind of fancy.
Well, yeah.
I think it's supposed to be
black tie wedding.
Oh, I hope it's fancy.
Sicily.
I'm wearing my suit.
We're going fancy.
I'm wearing my suit.
I'm
wearing
fake hair. Okay, I think I should get my hair fluffed like this. Thank you for assisting me, babe.
A hair assistant.
The installing is going down. Get you a man who's gonna install your pony.
I got there.
Make it tight like Haley does. Okay, last minute, just changed my outfit because I felt like my dress was just a little too much, you know? Kind of Vegas vibes. So let's see. Show you this dress. This most randomly trim outfit. We don't have a public mirror or anything. So this dress I got from Bloomingdale's the day before we left. It's just a cute little sparkly long sleeve. It's got this little ruching. It's like a V-neck and this little clutch I also got from Bloomingdale's. Clayton looks really nice. He's wearing his suit.
You said what?
Oh, there he is.
You said what?
You look really nice.
You look stunning, baby.
Thank you.
Going with the little
wife
white
suit.
White tank.
And his new boots. I'm gonna wear heels, but for now I have on
walking in
flip flops.
That's a smart move.
Clayton installed my hair. Great job.
I think it looks good. Finally found a full length mirror. All right, so we just got to Dean and Claudia's, what is this, the welcome drink party?
Mm-hmm.
Welcome drink party. Delaney and I were here for dinner the other night.
These are new shoes.
Cute. The ladies in their dresses. Looking cute.
And smile.
Cheers.
As many of you all know, Taormina is our home away from home. And we couldn't think of a more fitting place to welcome Dean into our family and welcome you all here to celebrate our love for one another. As a little girl, I fell in love with this beautiful town, and now as an adult, I return here to marry the love of my life.
Oh.
Dean, you are my everything, and I can't quite believe that with your kind soul, charming good looks, and outstanding talent for DIY, you chose me for your wife.
Presenting, first off, Michelle and Yuzina. Small but mighty. Okay, this all started because Michelle was talking about how she's quite strong. And then I said, do you think you could take Blake? And she said, oh yeah, very confidently. I got my money on Blake.
Okay.
I got Michelle.
Alright, are there any?
Are you not gonna do like a walkout or?
This seems, yeah. She's not that kind of girl, I guess. She's not that kind of fighter.
No.
Okay.
Never perform
okay.
Wrestling
okay.
Before,
okay.
Sorry.
Okay.
So I need a professional.
I'm not, but I'm gonna make a
UFC fighter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Put your elbow on the table. Your elbow has to stay on the table.
Okay.
Okay. You can stay like this until we go. Your elbow has to stay on the table the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, And we'll, what is the rule? They have to hold down for 5 seconds?
Yeah,
pen
of three.
Oh.
Are you nervous?
Okay. No, I'm not nervous. I'm never nervous. Never been nervous.
Never been nervous. Never but been. I am today. 3, 2, 1.
You started early. I should have strong.
It's even. That was pretty even. Okay, yeah. Michelle's the winner.
She is strong. You want to get in here?
Yeah.
You want to get in this?
Yes.
Oh, you go like this now.
What were you guys doing?
Like this.
Oh.
Oh, that wasn't it, y'all.
Oh,
yeah,
yeah. Oh shh.
2, 1. Oh, she's gone. Don't use your other arm. Oh, that was good.
She's strong.
She's strong.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys, today is the day. It is Black Day wedding day, and we're frantically getting ready right now. Me and Michelle and Blake's here. She's not coming to the wedding, but she's helping us get ready. And I pimped out my Instagram boyfriend like I always do. So Clayton is at Claudia's house right now with the bride, Claudia, and all of her bridesmaids. I'm filming a reel for them. So he is not ready at all. He hasn't showered, he hasn't got ready. He is over there. He's gonna have to run back here. We have to leave in like 15 minutes right now. So it's just very chaotic energy. And we don't even know how to like, get our dresses unwrinkled here. We just found an iron, so hopefully that's gonna work. We have silk dresses though, so it's kind of, it's just really chaotic energy. So this is just a friendly reminder. If you guys go to weddings and you feel this way too, it's so normal. Like, just down to the last minute. And also the lighting in this bathroom is so weird. It's very, very hard to do my makeup in here. It's just extremely overhead. There's like nowhere to go in the bathroom where it doesn't look weird. So we are just running around like crazy people. I'm gonna put my hair up in like an updo, I think, because it's really hot and we have to like walk all over town. There's no cars up here, so yeah, that's the vibe.
How's it going in here? Cute.
You know?
Yeah.
I wish that I could bring my green bag.
Are you bringing a bag?
A little one.
You are.
Oh, but what do we need to do about? We can't walk all the way over there. We need to bring a coat.
Oh, you guys, let's wear those bracelets.
I just ran across town.
The bracelets are on the table.
Now I'm dressed. Delaney's looking absolutely stunning. Hello, beautiful.
Hi, baby.
Where's your dress from?
Revolve.
Revolve. Just missing our heels. We're going to put the heels on when we get there. But we are running a little late. We're going to be on time here. We got to get out the door ASAP. Ladies. How's the walk? Are you doing all right?
Yeah.
Best way to do it.
Woo.
It's steaming. Yeah, we should get a gelato. We need a gelato for this one.
Okay, and just put on my shoes. Boyfriend goals.
Yeah.
Oh, God, you're and cocktail with you.
Cheers, guys. That was the most gorgeous wedding.
Stunning.
That was insane. And then we followed him in the car all the way here.
I'm so in love with you. Make me feel so brand new. I'll never be. Ooh, are you gonna sing this with me? Ooh, baby.
Like good wine may improve with every passing year.
Are you kidding?
Round of applause, everyone, come on.
Checked into our third and final place in Taormina. Mm-hmm. And it's actually our last day here too as well. But now we're at the Villa San Andrea's sister hotel up in the town. It's called the Hotel Grand Timeo. And our room is actually more of like a little apartment. It's got stairs in it, two stories. They have a bunch of different rooms at this location. This one is like a two-story kind of lofty deal, but it's been really cool staying here. It actually feels like you're kind of living here. It's like you're in a little apartment. Got like two bathrooms and stuff, but it's super pretty. It's our last day in Taormina. We leave for Madrid tomorrow morning. We gotta get in the car at 4 a.m. So that's gonna be pretty brutal. Just got out of the shower. Hair looks rough. Oh yeah, the wedding was absolutely
gorgeous.
Are you still tired?
You said you're sleepy.
Still been going to bed at like 1. It's hard to get to bed on time. On time for us being like 11. So.
Oh my god. You ran out.
Thanks.
You're gonna have like TikTok boy hair. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, do the face. Do the face. Wait, okay.
You're so much better.
Step by step. By the lip first. No. Why are you flaring your nostrils? Don't flare your nostrils. Don't flare.
I can't do it.
Don't flare your nostrils. What are you doing? Why are you flaring your nostrils?
I'm not flaring my nostrils. They're just big.
Oh, watch. I'm gonna give you a close up. Okay. Pause. Now make the face.
I am flaring them. But hold on, watch this.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Have you been putting on sunscreen on your face?
Yes.
You're getting a lot of freckles. They're really cute. Okay. But is it okay?
Yeah. Freckle boy. I have a lot of freckles.
Are they freckles or are they sunspots? Come here, come here, come here. Come here, come here. I don't know.
Your skin is like...
What does that mean?
I don't know, it's perfect.
What? What is this? What does that mean? What does that mean?
There's
what does
nothing
that mean?
Going on.
What does that mean? I don't really have freckles. I have moles.
It's very soft. Very
soft. Come, come, show me your freckles more.
These are French.
Clean, clean, grab it, grab it.
Oh. We just got to Lover's Cave, and he just told us the old fisherman's tale. Oh, here we are. Uh-oh, they're coming out with a baby. So the old tale is, if you really love somebody, you can go in this cave, and you'll come out the next year with a baby. So that's what we're dealing with. Delaney and I decided not to go into the cave today. Maybe we'll be back in a few years. But not right now. Is he taking us in there? What? That's the cave. That was so cool.
Okay. Dear vlog. You've been through some things. Yeah. You didn't even know it.
Vlog was underwater probably.
Yeah. You guys were underwater. How do we explain that? I tried to start vlogging right before.
First off, it comes up with my idea to go to a different bay.
The captain told
us. The captain
it's
said
really
it's very,
rough over
very rough. I said, oh, let's go and just see.
He said, no, it's not. Let's go over there. Yeah.
So we're on our way and it starts getting rough, rough. And then, like, fun. Three waves in a row. Two. And then the third one, we fully dunked. And we were all sitting on the bow, fully dunked.
Yeah,
the wave came all the way up.
Yep.
I think it went over us a little bit.
It hit our heads. We were sitting up and it hit our heads.
Yeah, it hit our heads.
Fisherman tail.
Yeah. And then we're sitting with all of our stuff. And
all of our electronics.
So everything
got chargers,
underwater.
Cameras, film cameras, phones.
You name it.
Yeah, everything was underwater. And then my phone was sliding down the front of the boat.
Bye.
Anyways, I chased the phone down the bow.
Yeah. We just were on Deadliest Catch.
It was Deadliest Catch, guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, I apologize to everybody.
Yeah. But, girls.
All the electronics work.
We made it through, but just barely.
I wish there was footage.
And then afterwards, we were locked like this.
Sliding off.
Blake was holding Blake's ankle. Blake was holding my kneecap.
Like a little stick shift.
Yeah, like steering the ship with my knobby knee. Michelle was on the
holding
end.
17 electronics. Thank God we just took that film picture of you and it wasn't right then.
Oh my God.
Because you would have slipped right off the boat.
I would have been off the boat.
That was, what, 30 seconds before that?
Yeah. It was honestly kind of awesome.
It was like,
I kind of liked it.
It would have been great if we didn't have our electronics and we were just like really living it.
That's what I said.
It was just fun.
Yeah.
Penso che un sogno così non ritorni mai più. Mi dipingevo le mani e la faccia di blu. Poi d'improvviso venivo dal vento rapito e incominciavo a volare nel cielo infinito.